Thanks very much, Madam Clerk. At this point, may I have the clerk please read the appointments and reappointments on the same agenda?
Yes, and when I call your name, will you please stand? First, we have item number 10, which is resolution of 2013-R56, to appoint Candace L. Street as a member of the Affordable Housing Trust Fund Advisory Board. Item number 11, resolution of 2013-R57, to appoint Henry T. Coleman Jr. as a member of the Affordable Housing Trust Fund Advisory Board. Item number 12, resolution of 2013-R58, to appoint Samuel F. Jones Jr. as a member of the Affordable Housing Trust Fund Advisory Board. Samuel Young. Item number 13 is resolution number 2013-R59, to appoint William S. Cooper Jr. as a member of the Affordable Housing Trust Fund Advisory Board. Item number 14, resolution number 2013-R60, to appoint Christopher C. Sterling as a member of the Affordable Housing Trust Fund Advisory Board. Item number 15, resolution number 2013-R61, to appoint Pauline N. Hyman as a member of the Affordable Housing Trust Fund Advisory Board. Pauline Hyman. Item number 16, resolution number 2013-R62, to appoint Doug Cole as a member of the City Planning Commission. To reappoint Doug Cole as a member of the City Planning Commission. Item number 17, resolution number 2013-R63, to appoint Carly U. Soriano as a member of the Community Criminal Justice Board. Item number 18, resolution number 2013-R64, to reappoint Michael Paul Johnson as a member of the Advisory Board of Recreation and Park. Item number 19, resolution number 2013-R65, to appoint Michael J. Gilbert as a member of the Advisory Board of Recreation and Park. Item number 20, resolution number 2013-R66, to appoint Uzziah Anthony Harris as a member of the Advisory Board of Recreation and Park. Item number 21, resolution number 2013-R67, to appoint Raina P. Pennington as a member of the Career and Technical Education Commission. Item number 22, resolution number 2013-R68, to appoint Marian A. Price as a member of the Career and Technical Education Commission. Item number 23, resolution number 2013-R69, to appoint Harley A. Tommy III as a member of the Community Policy Management Team. Item number 24, resolution number 2013-R70, to appoint Nancy A. Toscano as a member of the Community Policy Management Team. Item number 25, resolution number 2013-R71, to appoint Claire Olson Shapiro as a member of the Board of Directors of Lewis Center for Town of Bar. Item number 27, resolution number 2013-R73, to reappoint William Francis Sharpley II as a member of the Richmond Behavioral Health Authority. And item number 28, resolution number 2013-R74, to reappoint Vicki L. Squire as a member of the Personnel Board. Mr. President, those are all of the appointment papers that I have for consideration this evening.
Thank you very much, Madam Clerk. On behalf of the City Council and the City of Richmond, thank you for your willingness to serve your local free time of the community and all the interest for you to make you really appreciate. After the papers are adopted, if you would please meet the Assistant City Clerk at the rear of the chamber on the left, she can direct her office where you can get this for you. Thank you. This one you can see. Are there any folks here that wish to speak in favor of any of these papers? Are there any folks here that wish to speak in opposition to any of these papers? Mr. Actor, if you would, as you come down, please identify which paper you're opposed to.
How about all of them? The name of Donald Badger. I don't know which way this kid is going. I would think the rightful thing to do is be on a compliment to the board. This could be a fake goes on this agenda here today, there's quite a few appointments, but there is no termination of their duty. I guess that's going to be decided at a later date. But I would say that a life of counsel would have a beginning and end to everything. So when you put something so broadly that folks can say how long they want to serve, no, only God knows. And that's not right to the way I see it. The city needs to start doing things, taking consideration of the people in the city. We're supposed to serve on the council, that's good and well. But we're the citizens who pay the cost and look beyond the people's nose. You show them the one thing, thank you.
Any other person speaking on the petition? Seeing none, bring it back to council for any discussion.
Mr. President.
Mr. Gilbert.
Thank you. I had a month's cost, I'm going to stay on item 14.
Mr. President, I mean, item number 12, 15, and 21 will be continued to the March 25th meeting as was in the motion to run president on this evening.
Very
good.
Can we do that by a separate vote
after the voting? Yes.
Very good. Thank you.
Council is now voting on the appointment and reappointment papers as presented. Mr. Belisle?
Aye.
Ms. Graziano?
Aye.
Ms. Mosey?
Aye.
Vice President Robertson?
Aye.
Mr. Adelasco?
Aye.
Mr. Gilbert?
Aye. That's number 14.
Mr. Randall?
Aye.
Dr. Nino?
Aye.
President Sanders?
Aye.
Those papers have been adopted.
Very good. Now, we need to make a motion to wait for continuance on the other conference.
You think that we have the agenda amendments?
Thank you. Right. Nothing to read, let's move forward to a word of presentation.